You make a go crazy if you don't treat her like a lady. Treat her like a lady. See that girl. Watch that scene. Assalamu alaikum, habibati. Welcome to another Arab Man Reacts. Remzi and Lazi have prepped a little bit of an introduction about Selena so I know who she is. Feel free to listen to me read through it and go through it, or skip right through to the reaction. I'm going to put a marker down there. So she's a Mexican singer-songwriter. She was born in Texas in 1971. She is one of the most celebrated Mexican-American artists of all time. She is known for her contributions to music and fashion. Among her musical contributions, she stands out for being the first singer to formally name Tecnocumbia as a genre and a variant of Mexican cumbia. What is a cumbia? Tecnocumbia spread years later in Mexico, Central and South America. The sales of her records grew spectacularly, giving her a myth-like status. Her influence was such that People magazine dedicated a cover to her a week after her death. Rest in peace, Aleir Hamik. On March 31, 1995, she was shot and killed, wow, at the age of 23! By Yolanda Saldivar. Wow, dude, she was young. Yolanda was her friend and the former manager of her clothing boutiques. Holy cow. She was sentenced to life in prison. 2 weeks later, George Bush, then governor of Texas, declared April 16th as Selena Day. Wow, dude. Even after her death, Selena is still remembered and celebrated through concerts, documentaries, monuments, and her popular music. She has also influenced a new generation of Latinx musicians with her groundbreaking music, attitude, and style. And Como Una Flor, the song we're about to react to, is one of her signature songs. It was written and produced by her older brother, who was also a musician in her band Los Dinos, and her producer. Dude, there's some depth in this.
Yeah, but J-Lo basically portrayed Selena in a film in the 90s. She acted as Selena, Jennifer Lopez, and that basically launched her career as a...
No way. Yeah. All right, that's super cool. I don't know if you heard that, but basically... There's a film called Selena, and it's basically a portrayal of her life, and it starred Jennifer Lopez as Selena, and this was in 1997, and this actually was what gave J-Lo her, like, international moment. She won multiple awards for her performance in the movie, including a nomination for a Golden Globe. That is crazy. That is insane. All right, here we go. Selena... Como la Flor, live from Astrodome. Ahora,
me gustaría dedicar esta canción a todos ustedes, porque ustedes hicieron esta canción un éxito, el primer éxito para nosotros. Aquí en los Estados Unidos, igual como en México.
Dude, I noticed this about all these Mexican singers, is that they've got like, their vocals have this like layer of what do you call it? Like, it is magic, but you know, it's like, it's complex. It's like a baja, like a beautiful baja that's always underlaying what they're saying.
Espero que te acuerden esta canción. Como la blue.
Yalla, شو حلوة الموسيقى back then, dude. لا live auto-tune, no freaking effect, nothing. This is a human being's voice there on stage with on a microphone and speakers. No overproduction, no production. Now you get artists that just, I don't know why I'm ranting right now, but now you get artists that get on stage and they can't hit a note and everything is live auto-tune and it's like, and everyone's like, it's the meds. I'm loopy, okay? I'm loopy. That's all this is. A That's a nice lyric. She's adorable, man. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. I know how to lose, you know? It hurts. It still hurts. But I know how to lose, even though despite the hurt that's gonna come after I lose, I know how to lose. Who writes lyrics like this?
Her brother.
Her brother. It's something. It's something special. I need to watch that movie, Renzi. It's just so pure and I can't even, I don't even recognize her. I don't recognize J-Lo as J-Lo. Wow. How is that J-Lo, dude? Oh my God, it is. I'm going to. Maybe tonight. Like half of Texas is in that stadium. I don't think I'm understanding just how significant she was. Dude, this is a story, you know?
The woman who killed her was actually the president of her fan club.
Why though? What happened? So she was
the president of her fan club and she managed her boutiques.
Okay.
Selena had like...
Just imagine how successful she was, right? Besides the music and the performance, she had boutiques already. 23, she already has boutiques running.
So this woman was embezzling money.
Oh.
From everything. And Selena's family found out and they fired her.
Wow, dude. the thing is, she didn't just kill her, right? She destroyed a lot of lives by doing that. Because imagine the entire team involved in, like, the tours, the concerts, the production, behind the artist, the label, all of those people. Like, that's first degree getting affected, right? Them and her family. And then grow that circle to the people that weren't directly involved. Like, this is hundreds of thousands of lives affected by the death of one individual.
And millions of fans.
Yeah, and the millions and the millions of fans. Wow, dude. That is insane. You know what? She's also, it's not like this is what I love about singers like this. Like, she's on stage, but she's not putting on like a character or a face or an image. It's just her. This is me. I'm going to go. I'm going to smile when it makes me happy. You know, I'm going to get into it when I want. It's just, it's awesome. It's pure. I have no idea what you're
saying.
Okay. I'm guessing it's the last song in the set. Thank you for having me. You guys were beautiful. So elegant, man. There's got to be at least 100,000 people there. At least 100,000 people in that.
That's Selena. What do you think?
I think starters. I gave me some of them goosebumpers. It's sad, you know? It's very sad. Because this isn't one of those... A lot of the times artists are discovered after they pass. This wasn't the case. This is one of the biggest stars on earth. And she was only 23. Just think about this. What the pop charts look like would be different had she continued, because her sound wasn't just rooted in Latin America. No, it was in the States and it was becoming mainstream. I mean, George Bush made it Selena Day when she passed. So her voice and her art and her style would have grown and grown and grown and influenced other artists to go down that path. Literally, the Billboard Hot 100 today would not look the way it does now. The songs would sound different. The artists that we know would probably be different artists. Labels would be signing artists that are closer to her than to what we have now. Like, it's huge.
We got a lot more to go.
We do. So that's one thing. I'm definitely going to go down the Selena rabbit hole. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Was there anything that we missed? And do give me Selena recommendations. I want to watch the movie. That's definitely something I'm going to go do tonight. Thank you so much for watching. My apologies for being loopy. I am on some exquisite medication, I want to say. I'll catch you all in the next one. Papkun ktir. Salamat.